Hey guys, it's Ann Yorks from Flowerbox Bakery, and I have another really fun Valentine's Day tutorial for you. So since we have the new Sugarbelle Animal Shapeshifters set just came in, and animals make great Valentine cookies because you can just have so much fun with the puns. So today we're going to make a Hogs and Kisses pig cookie. We're also gonna make some skunks for your so stinking cute, or if you're not a Valentine's Day fan, maybe love stinks. And then I'm also gonna show you how to make a really cute hedgehog cookie so that you can give out some hedge hugs. Get it? Okay. But I wanted to let you know that with the Sugarbelle sets, it does come with these really cool and helpful instructional cards. So we're gonna be following kind of those guidelines for a couple of the projects. I'll show you how to use the stencil that comes with the cookie cutter, so I'll use that in the video. And then with the hedgehog, I actually wanted to put my own twist on it, so I'm gonna show you how I do that. So let's get started with the decorating. Let's start with the pig cookie cutter. I'm going to outline the cookie with tip number 2, and I'm using Georgia peach from Chef Master for that really pretty pinkish hue. Now, I had a little mispipe there, so you can see I just go in with my 2-in-1 tool and clean off the mistake and repipe it, and it's really like nothing happened. Then I'll flood in the face using my tipless bag and just tap the icing into place. And before I pop this in front of the fan, I'm just gonna add some of these black pearls for eyes. These come with the Sugarbelle unicorn candy set. Now we let that head area dry for an hour in front of the fan, and we come back and flood the body. That'll create that nice little line of definition between the head and the body. And I just like to wiggle my scribe in there to even out the icing. When I add the snout, that's still Georgia peach. It's just a lighter shade, just a little less food coloring in there. And I add his little nostrils with the darker Georgia peach. So we're really only using 2 icing colors for this cookie, which is awesome. Now it's time to add his little hooves. And so I didn't have to mix any more icing, I actually used a black food marker. For the ears, we're gonna do a little trick that I learned from Sugarbelle herself. We're gonna pipe the ears using tip number 352, and that's a leaf tip. And I just make sure I dig that tip of the leaf into the icing to create that little line. And now for the smooch on the cheek. I just add a couple of guidelines for the thin and thick areas of the lips. And then I just fill it in with some short strokes using the pink food color marker. Now, if adding those smooches with the marker is a little bit outside of your comfort zone, you could also use a Sugarbelle lips candy. And I just used a dot of icing on there to glue it on. This cookie is so simple and cute, but you can really dress it up just by adding a treat topper to the packaging. So I found this on Drawn by Krista's Etsy page. The Hogs and Kisses treat topper is the perfect accent for a classroom treat. Now let's take a look at the skunk cookie, and I'm just gonna trace the white guidelines for the tail. That'll just help when I'm flooding in the cookie. Again, I'm using tip number 2 to outline with piping icing. And then I'm going back in with my tipless bag, and I'm just flooding in the tail area with gray. And then I'll go back in with my white and reshape that little white accent on the skunk's tail. Now notice I'm not using black icing, the traditional color for a skunk, really because I don't like all black cookies. So I went with a charcoal gray. Now, one of the things that I find helpful, especially if I don't feel like dragging out a projector, is using a pattern sheet to create these royal icing transfers. So I'm gonna do that with these skunk faces. I'm using just one consistency of icing. It's 20-second icing, and I'm outlining and flooding that face all with the same icing consistency. Then I just go back in and add the white highlight on the face. And again, I'm using those black candies just like I did on the pig cookies for the eyes on the skunk. Then I'll let these dry overnight, And when I'm ready to decorate the skunk cookies the next day, they are ready to go. And it just makes those faces a lot easier than freehanding them or using a projector. Now on these skunk faces that I pre-made, notice I added a little pink in the ear area, and that is super cute. So if you wanna mix up a little bit of pink and add that in on a wet on wet dot, that would be awesome. Then I just drop it onto that wet section of the skunk's body and nudge it into place just so that it looks centered. And I'll let the whole cookie dry in front of a fan before I add the details to the face. I don't want to be pressing down on the surface of the cookie while that base icing is still wet. And I'm going to blush the cheeks with some carnation pink. This dust is FDA approved as edible, so this is my preferred way to blush cheeks. Pipe a little pink nose, and I'm gonna just add a double wiggle for the mouth. And now this cookie is ready. It is so stinking cute, and I found these tags on Etsy as well. I also wanna show you that these cookie cutters are super versatile. So just with one flip, I didn't even change the icing colors. I also made a perfect cookie. I made this cute little gray cat as well, using the same cutter and same icing colors. I've saved my favorite cookie for last. This is my hedgehog cookie, and I wanted to do my own design. So I veered off a little bit from the Sugarbelle templates and created my own. You can download this on the blog post and you'll find that link in the status. And if you follow the blog post, I'll show you how to print and use this template on your cookie as well. So once I trace that guide onto my cookie with the yellow marker, I'm ready to outline, and I'm just gonna use tip number 2 again to create those outlines. And I like to work background to foreground. So I'm gonna pipe the background area first where the quills or the spines will be. And then after I let that dry for an hour, I'll go back in and flood in the main body. Now to create this little heart that the hedgehog is holding, I used another pattern sheet, just like I did with, oops, I dropped that into the wrong spot. Sometimes that happens, and this was the last heart that I have. So I'm actually just gonna pick that up and get it into position. Sometimes I'll have extras and I'll just pull it off and put on a new one. But in this case, I just need to wiggle that in place. Now, if you're looking to make your own royal icing transfers that fit with this template, you can find a downloadable pattern sheet for free on the blog post. So just follow that link in the status. Now again, I'm using the black candy pearls that you can get with the Sugarbelle unicorn set. And that just makes adding those eyes super quick and easy. Now it's time for the details. A little heart nose and a squiggle for the mouth. And I'm just gonna pipe the little hedgehog legs and feet. So just piped lines, and then using a little stronger hand pressure, I'll pipe those feet and add a couple details to the ears as well. And don't forget his hands. You wanna make it look like he's holding out that heart for Valentine's Day. So now I'm going to add the quills, and I want these to be a little bit more delicate. So I've sized my tip down to a tip number 1.5. And I'm just gonna work my way around with both colors of the brown. So for tips on the icing colors that I use, definitely check out the blog post. I'll list all of the icing colors that I used for each of these projects. We're almost done. It's just time to blush this little guy's cheeks. And again, I'm using the carnation pink to get him nice and rosy. I made two versions of this cookie. So one with the royal icing transfer that I just showed you. And then I have this other guy, he still needs his quills to be piped, but I actually popped a mini heart cookie onto the cookie surface. So he's like a cookie stack, which is double the cookie fun. So you could do it either way. packing up these cookies is lots of fun. There's lots of great tags and treat toppers available on Etsy. And I found this cute hedgehog tag that I used with the cookie box. For more packaging tips and suggestions, definitely check out the blog post, and I link to the packaging that I used in this video. Thank you so much for watching this video tutorial. And if you're looking for that animal cookie cutter set, you can find it on flowerboxbakery.com. Also, check down for a link to the blog post with additional tips on planning for icing, and some pattern sheets that I show in the video are also available for download for free on the blog post. Leave a comment and let me know if you have any questions. Until next time, happy decorating!